It's a brand new trading week. The index is up by a half of 1%, 35.6742. The broad all shares also higher by a third. All sub-indices are in the green except for two. Financials down by a tenth and mining and oil down by 0.75%. Joining us now for her take on the markets this week is April Lee Tan of COL Financial. April, good morning. Thank you so much for joining us. Hi.
Hi. Good morning, Mimi.
Good morning. So at 6,700, is this market getting stronger or what? Do you think it's establishing lower highs or higher highs already? Even if historically, I saw data that February is among the three worst months for Wall Street. And you know what they say, when whatever happens on Wall Street tends to spill over. So what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, it's performing well. Technically, well, I shared with you our outlook. Actually, I wasn't able to share with you the technical picture, but you know, the technical picture is actually very good because it seemed like if you look at the longer picture, we've already established a higher low, as you had mentioned. So that's very strong. And of course, in the US, we have a new high. So those are factors that are really quite positive from a technical perspective. But that said, of course, we're more conscious of the fundamental factors. So that's what we're, you know, like myself as an analyst, is paying attention to. Because of course, we know if the fundamental picture deteriorates, then the sustainability of the market strength might not be there.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of fundamentals, I mean, what will it take to keep stocks moving even higher? I mean, let's look at the calendar for this week. Tomorrow is big inflation day, and then we're getting industrial production jobs numbers for the rest of the week. Can we just pull up the graphics for the calendar so April could also see? But anyway, are you expecting good news from these data points that are in the pipeline for this week at least? What's the market pricing in? And I guess more importantly, do you think the market's getting it right? Or are we over underestimating certain factors?
Well, I think, you know, for us, it's the important thing is inflation, and that it keeps on trending lower. The problem is the January inflation that will come out will for sure be a low number relative to last month's, because we will be coming from a very high base last year. So we have that benefit of the base effect. So definitely the headline figure will be lower on a month-on-month. But you know, I think the BSP has already said they're going to keep interest rates high for the first half because they're worried about the threat of El Nino on inflation. So I think what would be valuable is looking at inflation on a month-to-month basis, on a month-on-month rather than on a year-on-year basis, at least for the next few months, you know, while we're having this high base effect. And probably there'll also be more monitoring food inflation, and of course the results of the consumer surveys, like what are their pain points, are they worried about inflation going forward, you know, inflation expectations, because you don't want it to go up, you want to anchor those expectations. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think that's one important thing, plus interest rates, and of course the US, like the debate is still on whether we're going to have a soft or a hard landing even to this day. So I guess we should also monitor data coming out of the U.S.
All right. Just very quickly, I was going over the research that you shared with us. The strategy is to be overweight in cash, overweight in bonds, and still underweight in equities. Isn't now the time to be greedy and just buy, buy, buy?
Well, you know, for us, because, okay, our view is the situation in the U.S., we're not in the soft landing camp. We're in the hard landing camp.
Okay.
And as you mentioned, even though the fundamentals in the Philippines look good, the sad truth is if something happens in the U.S., you know, we will be affected. We're vulnerable to it. We're saying, you know, you stay in cash. Keep some cash, because in case that happens, it really is an opportunity to buy stocks even cheaper. And at this point, while you're in cash, we're still enjoying high yields anyway. So might as well, you know, keep some money in cash and enjoy those high yields while they're still there.
All
because
right.
it looks like, you know, I mean, it's a consensus view, soft landing, hard landing, interest rates are going to go down, and it's not going to last forever. Mm-hmm. So that should be good for, you know, holding cash in the short term, at least anyway, and easy to deploy.
All right. So keep some dry powder. I think we're now ready for your blind item. Talk to us about this stock. Just very quickly, the stock that you like, don't tell us. Just describe and leave reviewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
Okay, so the stock that we're recommending belongs to a defensive sector. Mm-hmm. Of course, given the threat of, you know, volatility, you would want a sector and a stock that belongs, that, you know, will continue to enjoy resilient demand, notwithstanding whatever happens.
Okay.
We like it. As you can see, the stock price has been going down, so it hasn't been a favorite of the market. Valuations are reasonable. And, you know, the past few years, it suffered from high commodity prices. But now that commodity prices are going down, we believe that the profits will benefit.
Mm-hmm.
And the principals have given a pledge that they will buy their... you know, one of the problematic subsidiaries in 10 years in case it doesn't turn around. You know, I don't want to say what that subsidiary is, because if I tell you what it is, then everybody would know what the stock is.
All right, which they'll find out in the next 30 seconds. But thank you so much, April, for joining us. Always a pleasure to speak with you. Have a profitable week ahead.
Yeah, same to you. Have a good day.
All right.